basic structure of C++. The first slide shows the basic structure of C++ program. As you all are familiar with this structure because you learned this structure in C in previous semester. The only difference is that instead of stdioh, now we will be using iostreamh. So let's start with each and every statement written in the structure. The first two statements are called as pre-processing statements, as it contains hash, which is known as preprocessor directive. So what is preprocessing? Preprocessing is the phase of compilation before the actual execution. Now moving towards the header files. Header files are always indicated by .h extension. Header files are predefined files in C++ library using which we can create new program. Here we are using iostream.h and conio.h. Iostream means input output stream and conio means console input output. Iostream includes cout and cin that we are further discussing. And conio.h is used for console applications such as getch is included in conio.h. For getch is used to hold the output of program whenever it is executed. Now moving towards the main function. The main function is also called method is a function from which actual execution of a program starts. So here is the first C++ program. As you can see, program output will be my first C++ program. So to show this my first C++ program on the screen, we have to write this line of code. First two, as I told earlier, these are called as pre-processing statements. So first we write hash include iostream.h. After that we are writing hash include conio.h. Then the main function starts. As you all know, every function starts with opening curly bracket and ends with a closing curly bracket. So opening curly bracket, clear screen. Clear screen function is used to clear the screen whenever you execute a program repeated times. Okay, so here you can see the cout means is a output stream. Cout is called as output stream. After that you see the insertion operator, and the statement which you want to print on a screen should be written in pair of in a pair of double quotes. And so my first program is written in double quotes, and after that you have to give semicolon. After that you use getch to hold the output of the screen. So how to execute C++ program? For executing C++ programs we are using Turbo C, which you already used in the already used in previous semester in PCI subject. So first, to compile a program you should press Alt+F9 from keyboard, or you can directly go to the menu and select compile option. To execute a program you have to press Ctrl+F9 from keyboard, or you can directly use menu to run a program. Okay, so moving towards cout, the syntax of cout statement is cout insertion operator in double quotes. You have to write text to be displayed double quote completed semicolon. This cout function is defined within iostream.h. The text written within the double quotes will got displayed on the output screen as it is. The operator less than sign is called as insertion operator, which is used to display data on output screen. For example, cout insertion operator double quotes Hello every one. Double quotes completed, semicolon. Now moving towards cin. Cin is similar to your scanf. Cin, then extraction operator, variable name. It is also defined within a iostream.h. It is used to accept input from the standard input device, that is keyboard. The operator double greater than sign is called as extraction operator, which is used to receive data from the user or from the output screen. For example, cout and insertion operator in double quotes, enter your name. Say double quotes completed, semicolon, and after that we have to write cin, extraction operator, name, which is the variable name. This is similar to your printf scanf. The same example you can write in C as printf, in double quotes, enter your name, double quotes completed, semicolon, and scanf in bracket name. Next, moving towards the rules of C++ language. So there are some basic rules which we have to follow to write a C++ program. First is, every program should have a main function. As the name suggests itself, it is the main part of any program. So every program must have a main function. Second, every statement should be end with a semicolon. If you don't write a semicolon after any statement, it won't be considered as a statement, and you will get an error in the message box that statement is missing. Third, this language is case sensitive. Fourth, all the letters should be in lowercase. Now, comments. Comments are more useful as we are writing a program which is already known to us. But if someone else is using that program, then a programmer must give a comment that what actually the particular statement does. For giving comment, we can use two types of comments in C++, single line comment and multiple line comment. Single line comment starts with double backslash and multiple line comment starts with backward slash stars and end with star backward slash. Thank you.